Joining me now is former president of Mexico, Mr. Vicente Fox, joins me in studio. Mr. Fox, welcome.
Pleasure, Jim, and thank you for inviting me. Beautiful city, Toronto, unfortunate weather.
Yes, well.
A little bit wet and cold.
Story of our city, story of our summer. Senior Fox, you are now an active participant in the cannabis industry, and Mexico is driving towards cannabis legalization. What exactly is the status of the laws in Mexico pertaining to cannabis presently?
Okay, been an activist for 10 years now, so wow. It's been a long way to get to where we are, this magnificent burning industry. Mm-hmm. What is the situation in Mexico? It's number one, medical use has been approved about a year ago. And it's legal, but unfortunately, we don't yet have the regulation to operate that law. We had a change of government in between. The new government is just taking hold of the situation, and it's a very liberal government, so has not only announced to try to move fast with regulation on medical use, but also to open recreational use, which will make Mexico, together with Canada, the two leading nations that have approved both uses, and will go for the whole enchilada.
Mm-hmm. Okay, so how long do you think until regulations are in place so that patients can access medical cannabis?
Regulations, I think it should be no more than maybe 4, no longer than 8 weeks. Mm-hmm. And recreational use within the year. It will happen within the year.
Okay. Is there any concern that the medical, or the introduction of recreational rules will catalyze a reaction from the cartels who currently control that business?
Well, what we have as experience behind would be Colombia, that did have the same situation, very similar to Mexico, and things went fluently. They are operating right now on the medical use, not yet the recreational. But cartels, I think that they have diversified their income so much that, yes, they would be losing some income out of the cannabis space, but yet they have other criminal activities. And on the other hand, I think that what has happened with the industry in other places, like Canada, like United States, those that participated in the old illegal industry, at the very end, joined in when it became legal. And now our businessmen, our salesmen, our owners of small stores. Mm-hmm. So that's the process. It happens that the new industry, the legal industry, dominates totally over the old criminal industry.
Hmm. Interesting. You recently hosted a conference in Mexico in your home state of Guanajuato, and it was called CANAMEX, appropriately. Yeah. Tell me about that conference.
Well, that conference is sponsored and promoted by both of us, mm-hmm. Chiron, this company in the space of cannabis, Colombian Canadian company, which is the leading company in Latin America.
Chiron Life Sciences.
Chiron Life Sciences. And Centro Fox, which is the first presidential library outside of the United States. Hmm. And we run it now for second time, 1,500 top executives from all around the world, scientists, academics, governments. So everybody participated. Our whole idea of Centro Fox, together with Chiron, is to promote the industry, to promote the benefits of the industry, especially the ones related to medical use. And it's permeating, it's really people is catching the whole idea that we have a nice, good, burning industry, that we have already taken away this beautiful plant from the criminals, from the cartels, and now put it in hands of the business community, corporate world, government, with taxes, and I think everybody's very motivated and enthusiastic about the future.
Mm-hmm. There are different things permitted for different indications in different countries. The cannabis space medically is very confusing worldwide. Specifically to Mexico, have they limited the use of medical cannabis to just a few human ailments, or have they basically broadly opened up?
It's, according to the law, it's broadly opened up. Mm. And we're waiting for the regulation, but I don't think it will limit what already has been approved.
Sure.
So certainly would be for everybody. Chiron is already taking positions, looking for an acquisition of clinics, which we already did in Colombia. Mm-hmm. ELAN is the name of this clinic chain that has over 100,000 patients. Mm. We're looking in Mexico for at least 1 million and up to 3 million, which already exist, which already have patients having to get attendance for pain in their heads, for different problems like Alzheimer, mm-hmm. like else. And so once we have those chains of patients, then you start introducing the products. It's not going to be sold on the shelf. Really, Chiron is very professional in this, selling a package. So we make a diagnosis of the patient, then we determine what his needs are, then we gave him a prescription, and then we go hand by hand to guide him to the future so that he can really cure his problems.
Hmm. Interesting. Will Mexico permit exports? I mean, the reason I ask this is for companies like Chiron, Mexico potentially could be one of the lowest cost producers in the world. So if there's an export market, yes. Chiron could very much profit by that. Is that on the menu?
That is correct, and you're right. It's not for sure right now that Mexico will allow trading, exports and imports. But Mexico's economy is the most open economy in the world. We trade with 42 different economies. We have trade agreements. The most important one of them is North America, the trade agreement with Canada, United States and Mexico, which has the largest trade balance in the world, approaching $1 trillion US dollars a year. Hmm. So $1 million every year we trade between the three economies. I think that this industry, same as today is the automobile industry or the pharma industry, will integrate to NAFTA and be part of this trading world. But we need to wait the United States to go open on national terms, on mm-hmm. federal terms, because right now it's state by state. Mm-hmm. But if we have Canada and Mexico already open, national, federal, then United States will join in, and certainly it would be an excellent, excellent industry, creating jobs, creating wealth, and creating trade.
Sure. So the population of Mexico now is about what?
We're about 125 million.
So that's a pretty massive market.
It is, and 80% of them middle classes with purchasing power.
Sure.
That's why we're excited. Certainly it will be, together with Brazil, the two largest markets in Latin America by far.
Uh-huh. Wow. So is Chiron in a position now to take advantage immediately when the regulations come into place?
Of course. We already done our job. We have offices and executives in Brazil, in Chile, in Uruguay, in Argentina, in Peru, in Colombia, of course, where we have a modern state-of-the-art production source, which is going to be the most competitive cost related processing and growing the plant. Mm-hmm. And yes, I think the cost of producing and growing in Latin America would be 30%, 40% of the cost in Canada or United States. So this is a very competitive advantage.
Sure. Do you see a future where potentially Mexico, Colombia, companies like Chiron could actually dominate the global supply of cannabis as ingredients for medical products?
No doubt. And that's about to happen. It's moving pretty fast because Chiron, with its very sophisticated strategy, with its trade name and its top executives running the company, has already raised $100 million in the market, and it's investing very wisely, as I said, in producing in Colombia, in acquisitions, buying companies that are already in the marketplace, like this clinics and pharmacy places, to retail. And also we have already participating in the wellness industry with a product by the name of Cuida, which is a great name, and is now being marketed in Colombia. We're ready to start in Mexico as soon as the regulation comes in. So yes, the company is taking positions, is investing in the marketplace, is preparing and being ready for the moment that is approved. Then you move fast ahead and you dominate the space.
Sure. The rules in the rest of Latin America, are they more or less on pace with where Mexico and Colombia are at, or is it mixed like the United States?
As you know, we're in a new industry and everything is new. So you tend to take decisions by the day. And you have plans, but you adapt them to whatever is happening. Now, I guess with Canada now, as the leading nation in the world on the whole spectrum of cannabis, is showing and giving us the example of how to move now in other places. Israel is the leading country technology-wise. They really have advanced technology in the medical use and the recreational use. So everything is now getting experience. Everybody's getting more knowledge. And by the way, we have an agreement with Chiron and Centro Fox, which is the first presidential library outside of the United States, which is in the state of Guanajuato in Mexico, which is the library I lead. We're going to establish there a knowledge center, a research center with seminars, with a lot of information, a lot of training for the whole participants, not only consumers, not only patients, but mostly those who are going to attend those patients, doctors, hospitals, authorities. Authorities, governments need a lot of information. They are taking decisions without understanding the industry. So we have to have a strong PR programs to approach government, sit down with them, and discuss how this industry is going to be a very successful job creation industry, wealth creation industry, and enhancing economies throughout the world. It's a new world, it's a new sector of the economy, and I think it's going to be fantastic.
Okay. Well, that's great. I really appreciate your joining us today. Thank you very much for your input.
My pleasure, sir. Jim, we'll see you soon.
Definitely.
Again.